Alrighty, well, back again, everybody, and this time around, gonna give Torchlight 2 a go. I haven't played this one in a while. I might have to turn that down a little bit. So, let's give old Jenny a go. And, as stated on the Twitch description, I do use cheats, but I'm also playing hardcore mode too, so she's kinda overpowering, but not to the extent where she one-shots everything. I know where I have to go. Well, we got off to a bad start already. Oh, that got off to a shitty start. Can we mow, please? I think I'm underpowered for that area. And I can't go on that one either because I'm under level there as well. Okay, apparently I can't go down that way. Not so secret now, is it? For those who don't know about this game, it pretty much is a Diablo 2 clone, even down to the music. You're gonna find that some of this music sounds familiar. Thank you.
is a trap.
No, it looks like I'd be able to cross there. I'm gonna head back over here. I think it's a lower level. Yeah, this sounds like Diablo music. Or specifically Diablo 2.
Thank you.
can't go anywhere. I'll probably have to watch like a YouTube video or two or something. Maybe come back and I'll redo my key bindings or something, because that was another problem I was having. Yeah, but it's like you were saying earlier, it's just a matter of me fighting the fight enough times to know what kind of attacks he does and when to dodge and all that. Okay. Yeah, you'll probably have to remind me next time. Shopping list. Okay. And one other nice little thing this game has. Another game called Fate has this as well. It has a pet where you can dump off your inventory and give it all to him, and he'll run back into town and sell it for you. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Well, let's hope it don't crash like crazy. I watched a guy do a speed run of this. He'd sit here and click. He'd sit here and move this potion up and down on the menus. He was actually making money doing that. Oh wow. Damn, four sockets. Actually, mine can't do that. My mic and I think my headphones as well are both USB. They wouldn't fit in my controller. And here we go, cheating coming. Damn, that's a big old boy. Ha ha! This thing is huge! This skill is absolutely useless for a cannon. The cannon is actually an engineer weapon. So, I don't think any of the skills I have are going to be useful. Oh, you're talking about yourself. Okay, I think you're talking about me. Like, no, I don't have anything attached to my controller. But yeah, I think I did have a controller that had a... had that extra little headphone jack. So much for that. There we go. Alright, I'm gonna go on the browser real quick and look up blindness. Don't help at all. This is kind of a crappy wiki. So nobody really determined what blindness actually does. What I'm looking at is this ability here. And... oh, take it, Guitaro. That might have been another reason why I don't stream this game very often. I can't find a good spot to put my overlays. That's gonna have to do. Maybe. Yeah, maybe. Maybe. Oblivion? Yeah, probably if anything. I kinda wanna look at more of the older ones. Here we go. And I think I fought this boss once before. Once again, I'm gonna run get me something to eat real quick. Probably the same thing I got earlier. Probably another peanut butter sandwich and another Reese's tree.
I'll be back.
Okay, and I'm back. And having my usual peanut butter sandwich and a Reese's peanut butter tree. Pistol. course, it also means I pretty much have to reset all my skills now. It's pretty well balanced. Looking at the cheats. Oh. No biggie there. That music got repetitious. La 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 la. Having to listen to da la la like over and over again. Two, three, five, six, eight, ten. Basically, I want to get these all. To get rid of these, add them onto this. nice, that skills. There we go. Oh, cool. It automatically did it. Pretty laid back. Actually, a lot of it resembles Diablo 2 music. Oh shit, here we go. Nowhere else to go.
Right.
Too bad it wasn't poison damage. Yeah, sure seems like it. some shooting practice. How to put together a shopping list. So it's gonna be a minute and a half. So I'll just pretty much just kill some time until I get back. That's what a flammer is. I'm guessing that was level locked. There we go.
Huh?
Oh, and something else I noticed about the... I'll show you. This part here, I don't know if you can see it or not. Nope. Basically, whenever I kill a target, that target has a chance to blow up into a poison explosion. But what it also looks like is, if that explosion kills another monster, then that monster too also has a chance to explode. So yeah, I really want to level this one up. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, it is, for the most part, a Diablo clone. Even right down to the music. A lot of the music on this game's gonna sound pretty familiar. Except this one here is more cartoony. Here is I'm gonna switch characters. Yeah. It's a pretty decent game, but yeah, the frustration was really building up. Part of it's the difficulty of the fight itself, but part of it too is, to me, some fairly clunky controls. Next time I'll play, I'll probably have to go through and change all my key bindings and stuff. Yup. Oh, Skull, speaking of that, I lost my entire party yesterday. It's due to the web spell. I wasn't really paying attention to it, but it basically paralyzes you and also causes all monster attacks to automatically hit you. Nope. I deleted them all. Because the monsters are called Ettercaps. I think they actually cast web spells. Okay, real quick, I gotta run to the bathroom real fast. I'll be back. Yeah. It's definitely a difficulty I'm not used to.
I'll be back.
Yeah, I see that. Yeah, actually, read up on a little bit of trivia on that I'll be back, too. Originally, when he first did it for Terminator, Arnold wanted to say, I will be back. But, Cameron actually shot him down and said, no, just say I'll be back. So, they did both versions. But they tested out with the I'll be back. And the whole place just went nuts. So... Okay, and this guy here, this one here is my berserker. Yeah. Whereas, if I was the director and or the actor, I probably would be flipping burgers after a while because I would have went with the first one because it does make more sense. The guy's a robot, so he shouldn't be doing like catchphrasey type stuff. I would have went with, I will be back. And I probably would have spent the rest of my days in obscurity or something. Well, and here's a boss battle. Yep. The only two I care for. Jingle all the way. I think the only one I watched was, I think it was Twins. Yeah, I saw the CinemaSins version of it. Yeah, I'm not a fan of that film at all. Never seen it, and don't really care to. And here we go. Big bad boss. Oh, that was quick. Yep. And back when I was at, back in probably the 80s or 80s, possibly the 90s when I saw it, I basically knew nearly every single word on that show. I watched the crap out of it. Commando, Predator, I watched it fairly often, but not as much as Commando. I used to watch Total Recall fairly often. I think there might have been one or two more. I can't remember what they were right off the top of my head, though. Okay, that's what I thought. I gotta do at least three phases of this. I gotta figure out how to get back. Where the hell is my potion button? That might be why. No, can't do that. Maybe I have a total recall emote. I still got a... I can't remember if that was realistic or not. I think I saw like an astronaut being interviewed about that, like when they fall, when they fall out of Mars without a helmet, the eyeballs pop out and all that. It's cool as hell you have that picture. Totally forgot. it is. You just see their face just kind of like hang off their skull. It's like you'd have smallpox or something. Your face just gets covered in blisters and somehow all goes away and your face just falls off. Yep. Little defect in the mask. How long do you plan on staying up here?
2 weeks.
Are you bringing any fresh fruit with you?
2 weeks.
Oh, excuse me? 2 weeks. I don't understand you, ma'am.
2 weeks.
2 weeks! His disguise starts fucking up on him. Okay, apparently not. No. Get ready for a surprise! Gotta stay mobile here. Apparently I got more to go. Yeah, I remember him. Oh, God. Hi, I am Johnny Driver or something like that. Lovely weather we are having. Looks like, yeah, I'm gonna have to. Robert Picardo? The name sounds familiar. Okay, so destroys armor and DOT as well. And not a big fan of first-person shooters. From what little I've seen of it, it looks kind of like a Metal Gear Solid. Michael Ironside, yep. Yeah, he's done his fair share of movies, too. You've got a shit ton of emotes, dude. Is there anything special you have to do to get those? Oh, okay. Say, it'd be kind of cool to sit there and download your own. That being the case, I'd probably put them in the chat more often. Monkus? Never even heard of that one. Since you call BBTV where you can add your own emotes to your channel. Is there a limit to the amount of emotes you can add? Okay. So, gotta choose well, huh? Yeah, but just whisper it though. I'm probably not gonna be able to. I'm not gonna be able to break off of this game here and click the link. No idea what that was. There we go. Okay, I gotta look at what kind of skills I got here. The only range state during which. Directly in front of you. Oh, so this is an AoE attack. Okay, I thought it was single target. This is basically just puts a DOT on him. Okay, this one here, crits heal me. This one here, there's an execute mechanic. Not sure you can see that, but the execute increases the chance that you attack with both weapons at once. Charge rate is increased by 21. And then down here, I don't know if you'll be able to see this, but whenever you deal damage to enemies, this builds up, and when it reaches a max, you go into frenzy mode. Whereas all of your damage are crits. This one here, 50% chance of just increasing your attack, cast, and movement speed for like 5 seconds. Like I said, I haven't played this guy in a while, so more physical and cold damage. Yeah, this. They have to be frozen first. But if I kill a frozen enemy, it mobilizes anybody in the area. And it's 30% chance for them to freeze as well. And increases my ice armor by 30%. This one here, whenever I get hit. Oh, and this is our. Retaliation one, you counterattack all everything that hits you, you counterattack them. And Shadow Burst, don't care much about that. That's all that is. Shadowbind. You know what? I'll stick that there. And then Savage Rush. Okay, then. In all likelihood, it'll probably be third person. I'm pretty bad at first person. Basically, this guy is like the barbarian in Diablo 2. He's a melee powerhouse. Okay, so oh, okay. So, this ability here makes, if I choose to do nothing but single target attacks, those single target attacks will transfer 15% of the damage dealt to everyone else in the area. On the move. lion head. Cheetorama on that one. So that one's a keeper. So these here are actually keepers. So let me find the socket, guys. Let me double check this. Okay, this is gonna give me the gems back, but it's gonna destroy the item in the process. this can go either way. Let me see how much focus I have right now. A lot. So, in other words, I don't. Yeah, focus would drop if I got rid of that. So it had to be that. And I guess I'll have to cheat in a stat enchanter. I don't need any more focus points. And that's what it's gonna give me. Can't afford to lose my strength bonus either. Better. Didn't really want any focus in there, but strength takes a bit of a hit, vitality takes a bit of a hit. It's gotta be the only game I can think of where you have a fumbles. Where your attack doesn't do diddly squat for damage. Yeah. Yeah, if we do get a Christmas tree, I don't plan on getting one, but I'm pretty sure if everybody else in my family was planning on getting a Christmas tree, it's probably just going to be a cheap one. I mean, a lot of us aren't even going to be staying home for Christmas anyway. We're probably going to be going visiting other people. Am I out of potions? excuse me. 17%. Not doing that one. Electrical energy. Frost breath. Not really sure. Movement speed, attack cast, slows him down. Damn. She ticked up. Take some of the points out of Eviscerate and put it in Halvin. Wonder how that, wonder how brief that, brief delay is. I'll just go with that. Oh, what's this? Worry about it right now. Whoop. Money. Go. And I believe this is going to be the very, very final boss of this game. And I'm hoping it's just going to be a straight up boss battle. I don't have to like go unlocking stuff. Hello. That can't be the one and only battle. That's it, huh?
The Clockwork Core has protected the world from another for longer than even the Guardians can remember. As the core wound down, slip through. They brought destruction to the races of the world. They subjugated the powerful and concealed themselves well, awaiting the time when they could hold one true hero in their throne. One capable of destroying the Clockwork Core and throwing wide worlds. Yet they did not foresee that another hero would arise to stand
Purple Heart
them and seal the Netherum in their ethereal prison once more.
Oh, wow. Might be keeping that one. like to interrupt Chance better. What, I can't have all of them? Guess Killian don't like competition. Just extra damage. Well, it might be better than that. Oh, shoot. I'd have to... Because the only way execute works is if both weapons are exactly the same. That means I'd have... If I picked that one, I'd have to find another claw from somewhere. Chance to execute too. Yeah, I really can't use that one. It's actually worse. Bye-bye strength bonus. Guess that one didn't sell it.
Your fame has increased.
Okay, and then the way this game works is whenever you complete the storyline once, you can start all over with New Game Plus. But as a special added bonus, never seen this in any other game, if you complete that storyline again, you can do exactly the same thing again. Then it'll be New Game Plus Plus. And you can keep rinsing and repeating this as much as you want. Thing with that is I don't, right now he's level 67. I don't know what the starting level is for the New Game Plus Plus, and I don't know if you can revert back or not, but whoop, nope, it starts at 81, so glad they told me that. So it looks like I got a long ways to go. So this game has it. This is a the end game now is pretty much gonna be like a path of exile. You can all run maps. So, a 15-second duration on a 1-minute cooldown. Not worth it. Yeah. I'm almost glad I turned the music on. I'm just getting burnt out on vinyl. Otherwise, I'd be playing it. But, again, like I said earlier, too, some of this music kind of resembles Diablo 2 music. Like I said, this is pretty much the Path of Exile endgame right here. this is lagging. I bet my stream is buffering big time right now. Mimic. And get some better health potions too. Nice stat boost, unfortunately, it's dexterity. Just wasting space. Thank you. some mega. Where are the grand ones at? 5,400. Jack? So I got 5,200, basically 5,300 health, max health, and grand health potions will just barely heal me to full. Full bore falconet. Oh, that's for an engineer. Up. Oh, no, 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 no. This is just like the engineer shield basher, shield charge. I don't want to knock the monsters back. He's a melee character, not a ranged one. Let's see what hell's like. So far, I kind of like it. It puts a big old red red mask over him makes him easier to see. No, doesn't actually deal any damage. So far, I'm liking it. Thank you. And on this ability here, in case you're curious, basically, the more monsters you have around you, the more damage you deal. And you take less damage too, I just noticed that. Got a boss. Okay, gonna call that good. Armor's too low. Whoa, that's kind of nice. Half damage to secondary targets. It's basically an AoE weapon. Oh, and I forgot to mention this too. You get, you can pick up spell scrolls as well. Some of these are passive, but some of them are actually, you have to cast them. Oh. so this one here isn't all that great. It's got a 10-second cooldown. For that, and this game also has a shared stash too. Chance items. Nope. But I think the way transmuting works in this game, it pretty much works like the Horager cube in Diablo 2. Three of any gem, three of any of the same exact potion and whatnot, it'll upgrade it to the next one. Ears are starting to hurt. It's one of the reasons why I don't like wearing headphones. But anyway, that's about all it's gonna do. Or that's about gonna do it for me. I'm just gonna go ahead and shut her down at a good stopping point. Gotta get some breakfast going and gotta shower, shave, and all that. So, yeah. And plus, I gotta add this session too to my blog post. So still gonna be pretty busy this morning. But aside from that, hey, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that. And I should be on later on this evening, between 4 to 6 p.m. U.S. Central Time, and it will be Final Fantasy 14. But as far as how long I'll be playing, I don't know. If it's anything like that's been going on the past week, I'll probably only be on maybe like an hour or so, just long enough to run the hunts, and then after that, probably some other game. I'm guessing probably Baldur's Gate, possibly Dark Souls, or possibly even this game too. But as far as that goes, it's pretty much up in the air. But until then, though, take care, everybody, and see you all next time.